Where does Hawaii stand in its effort to be more food self-sufficient? And how are federal USDA resources being used in our islands? U.S. Department of Agriculture Deputy Secretary Krysta Harden is joining us this morning, along with U.S. Senator Mazie Hirono. They both say aloha to both of you.
Good morning, Ron.
Welcome to Hawaii.
Thank you. Good morning.
Good to see you. I'm going to start with you, Deputy Secretary, because your job is to strengthen the American agriculture economy and revitalize, if you will. You got a chance to go to Hawaii Island yesterday. First of all, tell me your impressions. I know you saw lava up close for the first time. That must have been pretty overwhelming.
It was. Yeah. It was. I saw a lot of cool things yesterday, but the lava is one that stands out.
Yeah.
But it was great to meet with the farmers. A lot of them have so much opportunity here. You really do. You have a year-round growing season, so we need to take better advantage of that.
Okay, I want to revisit some of that thoughts in a bit, but Senator, you folks went to Hilo as well. Tell me what that was like. I know you have a sense of pride when, you're taking a visitor, especially a top federal official like this, but what were some of the stories that they've seen?
For one thing, let me just say that the USDA support for research in Hawaii, their support for rural communities and their infrastructure needs, as well as helping to train new farmers in Hawaii, their presence is really critical to agriculture sustainability here. So for Deputy Secretary Harden to be here, to see for herself, to talk with the farmers, there's nothing like being on site to really get a much better sense. And my hope is that going forward that she'll have a so much better understanding of the challenges that we face in agriculture in Hawaii.
Certainly some difficult time. We've seen some video of you folks here yesterday. Uh-huh. What was that like when you heard the stories, you've seen some of the lava damage? I know today or tomorrow you folks are going back to talk about
yes.
the coffee berry borer, which has wreaked mm-hmm. havoc on
yes.
our industry. Your thoughts on what can the federal government do to help?
Well, first I'll say that the senator talks to me about these issues all the time in Washington, but there's no substitute for being here.
Right.
And I realized that yesterday, really mm-hmm. talking to the producers, listening to their concerns about a number of issues, and just seeing the lava itself and the impact it has on our environment is just amazing. It was nothing like being here.
How can we count on federal dollars? I mean, how do you translate this visit into monies to help the Hawaii people?
Well, it certainly gives me kind of the firsthand experience mm-hmm. to go back to colleagues in Washington at USDA and in other agencies as well and talk about what I saw here, what I learned, what I heard from producers and landowners, all the different challenges that they have. Mm-hmm. So it makes me a stronger advocate, I believe.
Yes. And especially when we focus on our concern about invasive species.
Absolutely.
And we visited one of the native forests, and there's albizia problems and challenges, as well as there is a fungus that is killing our ohia trees. Very concerning. And so these are all areas that the USDA research money can go a long way in helping us address and resolve.
I like what I heard earlier when she said that you've been telling her about these issues. But
every chance I guess.
Well, and I know the farmers appreciate that, and it's something to say the stories. It's a different story when you actually see the stories, and so hats off to you to continue to do the work.
And I want to thank our secretary for coming here, because it takes a lot. It's kind of a long way from Washington, D.C., but the commitment that she's made to talk with our people and to understand the passion, I've heard her use that word, the passion and the commitment that our farmers have. And by the way, today we're going to go visit a school, the Holiho Elementary School. The USDA is very involved in our nutrition programs in our schools. We'd like to see more local products in our schools, and we'll also be visiting with one of our farmer programs to enable new farmers to succeed, and another program that USDA supports.
Secretary Harden, thank you very much for your good work.
Thank you.
And I know the local people and the farmers are really looking forward to seeing what you can do. You're going to see something really alarming, though, when you get to see the coffee beer borer and the damage it's done on the coffee.
They found that research, too, by the way.
Yeah. Thank you very much. Senator, good to see you as always.
Thank you.